Hey Patty, Mark Newman here, and I'm with Tracy Fox of the Gene Stratton-Porter Historic Site. And man, is this a beautiful place. Tell me exactly where we are.
We are in Rome City, Indiana, up in northeastern Indiana at Gene's Cabin at Wildflower Woods. Many people might not know, but Gene Stratton-Porter is Indiana's best-selling female author. And when I say best-selling, she was on par with J.K. Rowling 100 years ago. And so we're happy to have her home here.
Yeah, so one of Indiana's great native daughters. She found great inspiration from this place. And folks at home can't see it right now, but we're looking out over an incredible lakefront vista. Sylvan Lake. Why did Jean choose this place to live?
She was inspired from her childhood by nature. So birds, butterflies, plants, flowers, anything natural. And we have plenty of that here in Indiana. As her inspiration was drained a little bit further south, she knew Sylvan Lake was undeveloped. She knew the wilds were still here. And so this drew her to her home here. She built this home right on the lake shore. As you mentioned, we've got 148 acres that people can explore and discover that same sort of natural inspiration that Jean found 100 years ago.
Yeah, so Jean came to be known as this great creative mind, a person, an entrepreneur before her time. What kind of things did she do that gave her that that title?
What didn't she do, Mark? Yeah. I mean, really, she started out as an author. She did watercolors. She was one of the first nature photographers. When you think about 60 pounds of camera gear and glass plate negatives, and she was using that to do nature photography. She was an early entrepreneur in founding her own movie studio. Her books were so wildly popular that, of course, everybody wanted to capitalize on that, make movies. She didn't care for the way they were done, so she said, I'll do it myself. She moved to California and founded her own studio.
Yeah, so, and we've seen some of the books that she has authored. They're here in the house. A number of the photographs that she shot are on the walls of the house. As I was driving in, I could feel just sort of a breath coming out of me as I was taking in the incredible landscape, the water, the grounds. She really was into having an incredible garden as well as having trails and pathways to walk on and find that sense of creative renewal as she was walking around here.
Exactly, and that's what we hope people experience when they come to visit us today, is just a chance to stop and take a little bit of a breath, whether you want to enjoy the formal gardens and the cultivated flowers, or maybe do a little fishing on the lake shore. We've got now almost 99 acres of restored wetlands and prairies that we think Jean would be thrilled about, to bring the birds back. So you can sit in our viewing blind and watch the birds and see if there are frogs out today, or what other critters might be around. So there really is a little something for everybody, whether it's history or being inspired by nature or just reading up on some of Jean's books, which hold up really well.
Amazing. Tracy, thank you so much for talking with us about Jean Stratton-Porter, her life and time, this beautiful house. Patty, back to you.